Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, we're going to talk about how C++ 23 fixed the reinterpret cast problem, but we're just now actually getting to test this feature in 2025. Pretty much fixed the reinterpret cast problem. Mostly. We're going to have to talk about some stuff. Now, you absolutely need to go to the video description to check out books and swag, because I've got some awesome puzzle books and I've got some awesome t-shirts, and you should go look at those description links. C++ 23 added this thing called start lifetime as, and there's also a start lifetime as array. Now, the idea is that you can change the type of a thing. So let's go ahead and make a quick demonstration. All right, I've just created this new integer. I'm guessing at least some of you have done this in the past. This is actually going to reinterpret the bits of that thing to be a floating point representation now. So you would want to do this and say you're gonna avoid any conversion warnings or anything like that. Now, we have undefined behavior in this code very clearly, and we can see zero is returned here. That's not actually the undefined behavior problem. It's the fact that, actually, I don't know why we're getting zero returned here. What is the floating point representation? 42. Let's go ahead and add some extra helpers here. All right, so it's a very small number because we've just reinterpreted those bits that were an integer as a float. And these things are both primitive types and they're the same size, so this is not safe. This is explicitly undefined behavior in the standard. So the problem is, at that memory location that I points to, I have an integer. I explicitly created an integer right here on line 9. And I'm trying to say, oh, just pretend like that's a float. The standard explicitly does not allow this. And to get into these like strict aliasing and all these rules that come down to trying to access things as things that they aren't ends up touching like 6 different parts of the standard. And I know every time I do an episode on this, I get a million complaints that tell me that I'm wrong, and I'm not wrong. You can go watch the other episodes on Reinterpret Cast or Jonathan Mueller's videos about object lifetime and C++. It's just, this is not legal. This is explicitly UB. Actually, that is not. This is. At the moment when I actually try to access the object as that type, then I have undefined behavior. And interestingly, C++ 26 has a little feature that lets us talk about this. We can cast in and out of void pointers at compile time in C++ 26. So maybe this will convince you, because the C++ standard does not allow undefined behavior during constant evaluation, and a const eval function is always executed at compile time. Let's go ahead and call it. And we should see that this is going to compile. Yes, because I haven't done anything naughty yet. This should fail to compile because I have an integer at that memory location, not a float. Here we go. Accessing value of type int object through a float gl value in a constant expression. It's undefined behavior. The compiler's not going to let me do it. I can round trip this pointer, however, like this. And now I am actually accessing the thing as the object that it actually is. Except I have to do that whole in and out of void. I'm still not allowed to do a reinterpret cast at compile time, but I can get approximately the same effect. All right, that compiles. So hopefully you trust me. And that's going to bring us to this start lifetime as. And if you still don't believe me, then you might have to ask yourself the question of why did the committee create an entirely new function called start lifetime as if reinterpret cast could legally do the job? And that's because reinterpret cast cannot legally do the job, but start lifetime as can. So I'm going to go ahead and reuse this float pointer. Now accessing this thing on line 35 is not undefined behavior. I've changed the type of that thing to be a float. This is now not UB. Now, unfortunately, I cannot test this in the const eval function because start lifetime as is not const expr. Now, I can't access that object through that integer pointer legally anymore because the object pointed to by that memory address is now a float. And if I try to access it via an integer pointer, I have undefined behavior again. We have this solution now. We can change the type of the object pointed to at an address at runtime with the start lifetime as. There is, of course, some caveats, and I'm going to go ahead at this point. I've already spent longer than I intended to talking about this example, and I'm going to paste in an example that I created earlier. I'll make sure that the GitHub issue for this episode has all of this information. So let's start here. I've got this process data function, and I've got some sort of blob. This is a blob of bytes that have come off the wire. This is what you tend to think of when you want to use reinterpret cast. Some network device read or from deserialization or something. Now, I've created this handy little as function for myself here to deal with a couple of things. And notice that I do have the comments from the standard in here. So my little as helper, it takes a pointer to some character data and a size. It would be better to have used a span here, honestly. Let's go ahead and change that real quick. All right, there's a few things going on here. Now, first of all, I'm actually forced to do a reinterpret cast here, which I find terribly ironic. But the problem is, if the data coming in is not properly aligned to the alignment that is required by the object that I want to start the lifetime as, then I have undefined behavior again. And the standard explicitly says the behavior is undefined if this region of allocated storage is whatever, reachable through P, okay, whatever. So it has to be a valid memory address range. And the region is not suitably aligned for the T, okay? So I am doing an assertion on line 21, and this could in C++ 26 become a contract precondition. I am checking the alignment of the pointer to the data to make sure that it is the same as the alignment that is required by my data type. And now I have a second assertion to make sure that I am exactly evenly dividing the number of bytes for my result type into the number of bytes that were given to me so that I make sure that I am reading within a valid range. And then I compute the number of elements that will actually be created by doing a simple divide of the size of the result and the size of the input. And then I'm saying start lifetime as array, and I'm giving it the result type, and I'm saying this is an array of num elements. And I also then have to pass num elements again to span. So then in the return statement, I have a safe span into this data. And I can see here the process data function, which takes a span of values that was created by my handy helper as. This is the kind of thing I totally expect you're going to have to go back and look at the code more closely, see what questions you have. And I'm just doing some random computations on these things. I don't know, I'm playing with different things. And the point is to show that the compiler can see through all of this, and it does like a very clean loop over the elements and a modification of the data at those memory locations. We're not getting any extra overhead. We're just being correct within the memory model of the C++ standard that we're telling the runtime we have changed the lifetime of this thing. Are you going to see a practical difference in your code? Probably not, but you can avoid undefined behavior if you use this correctly. All right, hopefully that made sense. Maybe you'll have to watch it twice, I don't know. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I have been waiting literally 4 years to make this episode so that I can finally tell students there is an actual answer to this problem that doesn't require memcopy tricks and doesn't require reinterpret cast. And you can actually implement this kind of thing without undefined behavior now. So go ahead and check out the code sample. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week.